Mass is the amount of matter of an object. Mass is the gravitational charge of an object. Mass is the measurement of inertia of an object. If you went to school, you may recognize all three and say, well, all of them are correct. But isn't it suspicious that a physical quantity has three different definitions? It is very suspicious. Today we will answer the first two. We've already answered the last one in another episode. Well, it turns out that we can group all these definitions into a single one. Here we go. Mass is the amount of energy an object has while it's standing still. Period. Remember E equals mc squared? Well, that is only true when you are not moving. If the object has any velocity larger than zero, then the equation becomes much more complicated. How does m equal e over c squared explain gravitational charge, though? Easy. Look at the gravitational equations. This is the complete picture of how gravity works. Not this, this. Not this, this. And here, in this term, you can use as an input the energy of an object. But that's the total energy. Not just its mass, because even photons, which don't have any mass, still attract other objects gravitationally. So is mass really the gravitational charge? Not really, because gravitational charge doesn't depend only on the energy when an object is standing still, also known as mass, but also its momentum. Is mass the amount of matter of an object then? This is a hot cup of tea, and this is a cold cup of tea. Other than the temperature, they have everything else identical. So, since the left one is hotter, that means its molecules have more energy. But the cup of tea is standing still. So, combining these two facts together, A, more energy, and B, standing still, means, yep, the hot cup of tea has more mass. But how much more mass? Let's measure it. 60 degrees Celsius T versus 20 degrees Celsius T. That's a 40 degrees Celsius difference, which is 75,964 joules of energy. M equals C over C squared. And that means not very big of a difference. That's why the amount of matter is good, but just not perfect. Amount of energy is better. So what mass really is the net energy that is left after summing many sub-objects into one object. That's not the same thing as adding all the individual masses together, though. Just like the total force is just the net force after combining all sub-forces, but not adding all the forces together, just like the net force of an object can be smaller than its individual forces, mass can be smaller than the sum of its parts. If we wanted to, we could figure out what type of energy is hiding behind every object which has mass above zero. But still, there are tons of more questions to ask, like, if mass is energy while standing still, then why does that energy make objects harder to accelerate? Does mass increase as the velocity approaches the speed of light? If E equals mc squared and photons have energy, then why do photons don't have mass? Be sure to check the channel for the answers to these questions as well.